How do we define addiction? How do we define the problem? Well, quite simply, we view addiction as a worship disorder that originates in the heart of mankind and nowhere else. Now, when we talk about heart, we don't mean the beating heart that pumps blood into, every part of our bodies. We believe the heart is the seat of our passions. It's our desires. And so our desires are what are in our hearts, and our desires are for our flesh until we're born again. And so we're helping people to understand that their heart desires are the problem. We could get rid of all the package stores, all the drug dealers, and people would still find something to abuse or to mistreat or to use to excess. It could be anything, food, sex. It doesn't have to be a drug or alcohol, which is a drug in liquid form. It doesn't have to be something like that. It can be anything that people use to excess for pleasure. If you look at Isaiah 44, 9 through 20, you'll see how the idolater uses a tool to carve out his idol. Well, that's what cocaine is. It's a tool that the idolater is using to carve out their idol, which is the idol of self. They're living for self. They love what cocaine does for them, and that's the tool they use. Others of us have different tools. You, if you're a listener right now, you have had a tool that you use. I have tools that I have used. We have tools that we use to carve out our idols of self, of living for self, when self is in the throne seat of God, and I would say wrongfully placed there. We put ourselves in the throne of God and act like we are God until things spiral out of control and we need God. And we say, oh God, I need you. Will you help me? Will you rescue me? I don't want to sit on this throne anymore. And then we get off of the throne, we get God's help. And then it's not long after till many of us sit back up, sneak back up to the throne and sit right there where we shouldn't. And we become like an idolater in that moment. And so we believe that grace-filled, truth-saturated care and counsel are necessary to correct the problem of addiction in the heart of man. We believe it's loving and compassionate to treat the addicted and their families with respect and concern for their souls, and that addiction problems may appear to be issues primarily in this life, but we believe there's a simultaneous eternal issue at stake.